underground structures and above ground structures, and possibility for integration of data obtained from different sources. Some word about the classical technique for underground mapping. Classical instruments are meter, compass, clinometer. In more recent years, it is total stations and theodolites. This is a reliable equipment for underground mapping, but lack enough information for to be able to fully reconstruct the underground structure. There is a too low number of measured points, so we can reconstruct the overall size and shape of the structure, but it is not enough to make precise model. So for this reason, the next logical step is 3D scanners. This equipment is similar to total station, but make not single scan only of distance and azimuth and elevation of the point, but a huge number of scans each second. Each scan is automatically generated, so it works without human intervention. During this process are generated so-called point clouds. It is a matrix of the old data that are collected during the scans. Data contain the coordinates of each point and may contain also some additional information, for example, intensity of reflections. Such scanner system can scan almost 36 degree panorama, so it is very useful for scanning such underground structures. We are not pioneer in using TLS for underground structures. The first known to us surveys are done in 2004 from Corrier, who explored Vamis Caves in Scotland. Since then, there is several such surveys. Our results, as expected, are very precise and allow the teams that perform such scans to reconstruct with great precision the shape of the structure, geometrical shape. Of course, it is possible to parallel with laser scanning to perform photograph and to create orthophoto map of underground structure that can be applied over the 3D model generated by laser scanner. In this case, we can colorize the underground structure that give additional level of information for the object that we study. Here we collect what we find about such surveys, underground surveys. There is not a lot of there is a limited number of such surveys because it is not very easy to perform and it is require a lot of resources. What we find interesting, it is a different technique for perform laser scans. I will explain in next slide what I mean for a construction of 3D model. Different duration of the surveys, different size of the cavities, and the number of the point clouds that are generated during the surveys. Some take a long time to be performed, for example 20 days. Another evaluate long caves, for example 17,000 meters. In our survey, we take only 2 days and choose a relatively short cave, but we try to do very dense picture of this cave, so we generate a huge number of scans and point clouds compared to other surveys in order to try to obtain the best possible resolution for a 3D model that we created. How this is performed? This is for aerial aerophoto mapping. This is the same for a drone or for a manned airplane. The technique collects a number of 2D pictures at regular basis. Idea is to stitch the pictures in order to generate large orthophoto map. Software that stitch the pictures in the process of stitching generate so-called point cloud. It is the same as a point cloud generated from laser scanner. It is the individual points with coordinates in 3D space. So because this information is similar with laser scanner, it is possible to make 3D reconstruction of the terrain objects. So we can produce two products. One product is orthophoto map. It is 2D product. And other is 3D structure representing relief. Of course, we can combine two products and place orthophoto map over the 3D structures to obtain the very good representation of relief, something like Google Earth. Okay, how data from orthophoto mapping and laser scanning can be integrated? There is several approaches. The most straightforward is when the photographs and laser scanner are based on the same platform. In this case, there is no problems with the format of data, synchronization in time, in coordinates. So it is the best case and easier for software and for a person that perform integration to combine two types of data. Of course, in case usage of drone is not straightforward, so we must use two different type of equipment, and in this case task is significantly more complex because the data are in different formats from different brand of techniques with usually they can use different coordinate system. So straightforward integration in one software is not so easy. In this case, we can use different approach to process two type of data separately and to combine the result of processing, because a result is more clear and more under well defined, and task for integration in some cases are more straightforward. Of course, this is not absolute. In some cases, integration of data at row level is more applicable, but this depends from the equipment, task, software, and many other questions. What software are appropriate for such task and what we use? From left, there are softwares that are more appropriate for photogrammetry. It is combining the 2D pictures for processing of the orthophoto and 3D model. Of course, they have ability to work with laser point cloud. In our case, we use mainly Pix4D and reality capture and MetaShape. We can use another kind of softwares, mainly from geographical information systems like QGIS, ArcGIS, for Blender, for integration of models and place of the model on the global map. Where we perform our studies, we use several cases for our studies, but our current study is focused on two caves. One of the caves, Prohodna cave, is we choose this one because it is large and it is suitable for laser scanner to be used inside the cave. Another cave is a Duhlata cave. It is significantly more complicated to use laser scanner inside, and in this case we use classical mapping of the cave. This is the cave with difficult access. It is a biggest cave in Bulgaria. It is a 6 floors, over 20 kilometers, several underground rivers. You can see very nice picture from this cave. It is in difficult for access karst region. Only for a preview here on 2D map, we mark points where there is a hole. From some holes, cave can be accessed. From some hole, it cannot be accessed. How we perform our survey? There is two part: underground cave mapping. For underground cave mapping, we use classical mapping techniques. It's at earlier mapping was performed using meter, geologic compass, and inclinometers. All data are writing or paper. In the recent years, we use a more advanced equipment like electronic laser range finder that generate all measurements in one single pass. For above ground, we use drone with visual and thermal camera. This is the result from 3D integration. This is 3D model of the underground caves. This is the 3D model of the terrain with high resolution orthophoto. And here you can see integration of the underground cave on the overall terrain structure. We have no time, so I will try to hurry up. This is second cave. It is huge, very beautiful. Here we do the similar thing, but we use terrestrial laser scanner for underground mapping. Here we establish a network of control points with precise GNSS receiver to be used as a stations for measurement. This is a different type of laser 3D scanners. This is our scanner. This is a technology how laser scans can be combined. We use such metal spheres to on the place that can be used as control points to match the different scans. This is a real scanning of the area. We capture a huge region in this field. So in our case, we use an approach with separate processing of data. Laser scans are processed separately from the aerial scans. Here you see the results. This is a 3D laser scanned model of the underground structure. Here is the same in the volume box. And here you can see the, this is not the picture, this is the, from the reconstructed 3D model. You see how close this reconstruction is to the real pictures for the cave. This is a result from drone scanning and modeling. There is a very good 3D reconstruction of the above ground structures. And here we combine the results from the two scans, above ground and underground. It is not so easy to display underground and above ground on the same picture, but we try to make some visual representation. Here you can see the cave, 3D cave model, and this is the ground level, but we see this from the underground. Maybe this is not very clear for a person that not use such techniques, but this is our first approach to combine and to make some visual representation. This is view from above, this is view from the underground. So this is a new field of the research, because such high end equipment is available only in the recent year for mass use, and it became very interesting to perform such surveys with the above ground and underground scans. It have a wide number of applications. There is no time to discuss each one. Underground environment is significant challenge because access is hard, but there is novel equipment that is small size that can be used inside the cave. So we hope that in the next project we can have a better result. And finally, this research was funded by National Science Fund at the Bulgarian Ministry of Education. So, and the leader of the project is Professor Yavor Shopov. Thank you for attention.